This is the upbeat image North Korea wants to project to the world. Extensive coverage on state-run media of leader Kim Jong-un presiding over projects that improve people's lives, like this housing development in Pyongyang. Or of happy citizens taking part in a drawing and calligraphy festival to coincide with the Day of the Sun. And good news features such as this one about a flourishing tea culture, thanks to the beneficence of North Korea's leader.
The respected General Secretary took measures to build this tea factory so that people could have tea at any time and place.
But domestically, Kim Jong-un has had to deliver a far more somber assessment of the multiple problems his country is facing and that his people are all too aware of. More than a year of self-imposed isolation because of the pandemic has compounded the impact of ongoing international sanctions and food shortages from last year's storms that ruined crops.
I ask party members at all levels to wage another more difficult, arduous march in order to relieve the people's hardships as they follow their party as their mother.
The arduous march is the euphemism for the famine North Korea suffered during the 1990s, following the collapse of its ally, the Soviet Union, and failed harvests. Kim Jong-un's comparison with those grim days seems to be the clearest admission yet of the extent of his country's problems. More proof of the North's isolation came with the announcement it won't be taking part in the upcoming Tokyo Olympics, dashing South Korean hopes of trying to revive diplomacy around contacts at the Games. But state-run media has focused attention instead on athletes training for Games to mark the Day of the Sun, as further evidence that on this most important day in North Korea's calendar, everything is just fine. Rob McBride, Al Jazeera, Seoul.